In this video, Ancilla will be introduced. Ancilla bits help us make irreversible functions reversible. To review, quantum computation is reversible. We don't want to lose any qubit information during computation, before measurement or observing the value of qubits. We want to make sure that all functions represented by some arbitrary matrix U are reversible. What does that mean exactly? That means that input can be recovered using the output in the inverse function U raised to the negative one. For example, if we have original input, here we have psi zero, that'll be transformed by a matrix U to get psi one. If we take the inverse function, U raised to the negative one, and multiply that by the vector psi one, we will get our original vector psi zero. The requirements for reversibility are as follows. We have to have the same number of inputs and outputs. Each input must map to one unique output, and each output must map to one unique input. These are some of the properties that allow us to reverse quantum computation. Let's look at an example with the CNOT operation. Each basis that we have for CNOT, so that includes ket 00, ket 01, ket 10, ket 11, they all produce a unique basis output. We also want to note how each input and output has two qubits associated with it. As a review, how do we get this information on the truth table? We can take the vector representation of our input values and multiply that with the CNOT matrix. How do we make irreversible functions reversible? We can add extra resources, we'll call those Ancilla, to make irreversible functions reversible. Here we have the AND truth table that tells us what our single output bit will be from our two input bits. And we know that the output of the AND operation will equal one if and only if both input bits are equal to one. We can see that with the visual representation of the gate here. We only get an output of one if both inputs are equal to one, or if we have two black balls entering the gate, we result in a black ball output. Let's make the AND gate reversible. In step one, we need to make the number of inputs and outputs the same. First, we are going to pass the top argument from in to out. So we can see that done here. Second, we're going to take the output of the original AND operation. So here we have white ball, black ball for the case where we have two inputs equal to ket one, and then white ball. Unfortunately, this function is still not reversible. We have two choices that have the same output, and that violates our rules for a reversible function. Each input must have a unique output. With only two inputs and two outputs, it's impossible for us to make the AND gate reversible. We need to add more bits. In step two, we will add a third input, and we'll call this an Ancilla bit. We add a third input to all of these gates, and we'll go ahead and give that value of a white ball or a zero. Now we need to assign values to all of these, so these assignments can be arbitrary. We just need to make sure that we assign values such that each output is unique for each input combination. The AND gate is now reversible. To conclude, we were able to make the AND gate reversible by adding Ancilla bit. So let's look at the truth table. And just for clarification, when we look at this truth table, we are using top down, right left for our bit placement. So for example, here we have white ball, white ball, white ball, white ball, white ball, white ball, which will be all zeros. And then for here, if we had 100, 100, we can see that our output of 100 maps here. So we're going from right to left. We have our original function for the AND gate. So that includes these two input bits and then this center column of output bits. And by adding Ancilla and extra outputs, we were able to transform AND so that it can now be a reversible implementation. In summary, irreversible functions, such as most classical computations, can be made reversible by adding Ancilla. Here we learned that with Ancilla, we can make input and output combinations unique, and this is a requirement for reversibility. Here, we just implemented a basic technique to make AND reversible, but many efficient algorithms to generate reversible functions from classical logic exist.